My name is Donovan from Wondershare, and today I want to address a question for you. And that question is, what is a video converter? And to address that question, I want to set up a little scenario for you that I think a lot of us have found ourselves in, and that is, we're trying to use a device, but we're finding that that device isn't supporting the video format that we want to use. And I know it's something that's happened to me before, and it can be really irritating. Videos are all around us, and though this word sounds simple, there are a whole lot of specifications revolving around it. So the very first thing, what exactly is a video format? Let's start with the basics first. There's a video format, and then there's video encoding. When we say a video format, we basically mean the video packing format that can be considered like an outer case or a drawer where you keep all of the video related information, like the video, the audio, and other details. Next comes the video encoding. This is the technology that we use for processing and compressing the video information. So now when I talk about video conversion, it can be the conversion of the packing format or the conversion of the encoding method that is used. So let me give you an example. Let's say you have a container having the apples. These are the video files. So the apple may be in the form of a whole apple, a pie, or the puree, different formats of the video files. So now when you want to try any of these Apple products, what will you do? You'll open the container first, right? So here, opening the container means opening the video file using the player. Now let's assume that you're not able to open this container that has the apples, which means your player is not able to open and play the video file. First, we'll try to change the container, which means we are changing the packaging format. If that method works, it's great. But what if it still doesn't work? So the next step would be to change the form of the apple. That means changing the whole apple to a pie or puree so that it can be opened using the player. This method, if it works, will be termed as a change in the encoding method. So when I use a video converter tool, the software converts the video format and not the encoding method. I hope it's clear to you now that we actually meant by changing the video packaging format and changing the encoding method. So now that you know what video converters do, the main question is, when does the need for video converters arise? These might be several situations when I would want to use a good video conversion tool. Several times the format and the codec of my video file are not supported by my computer, and thus these files fail to play, and here I look for a good conversion tool. During my travels, I have ample free time when I want to watch my favorite movies, TV series, or other videos. To convert the disc and large video files into a smartphone compatible format, I again use a conversion tool. I record my favorite TV series, but the format is not compatible with the players and devices that I have. Here also, I need a conversion tool to convert these videos to MP4 that is compatible with the majority of the devices that I own. So what is a good video converter? Now that I've decided to use a conversion tool, it is important to select a good one to ensure that there's no loss of video quality and the task is hassle-free. To me, a good video program is one that supports maximum number of formats to take care of all my conversion types and processes my files at a super fast speed so I do not have to wait for a long while converting large and multiple files. The easy and simple conversion process is also important to have an effortless experience. After analyzing several tools, I recommend Wondershare Uniconverter as the best conversion program. This is an excellent software that seamlessly works on my Windows and Mac systems and assists in quick and hassle-free format conversion. With support to more than 1,000 formats, I do not have to worry about compatibility issues while working with Uniconverter. Moreover, when I require playing a certain video on a special device like a phone, Android, and others, this is just the perfect software as it supports an array of preset device-specific formats. I can add videos from my local computer, as well as directly from my camcorder, mobile phones, and other devices to the software interface for the conversion task. At times, I wish I could remove certain parts of the video, and Wondershare software is perfect for just that task. There's a built-in editor in the software that I can use to remove unwanted video parts, crop files, and add subtitles to the video, add a watermark, rotate, and perform a host of other useful features. So using Wondershare, I created an awesome customized video for my wife on her anniversary, which made her extremely happy, thanks to this amazing software. Once, I needed to merge multiple small video segments to create a project for my son in school, and here also Wondershare Uniconverter came to my rescue. Using this software, I could merge all the videos and the project was ready in just a few minutes. Whoa! Moreover, I also compressed the anniversary video, school project, and my other video files using the software so that I could create some additional space and accommodate a few more files on my computer. Did I forget to tell you that Wondershare Uniconverter can also be used for many other tasks? Well, just to name a few, this amazing software not only helped to convert the video files that I mentioned earlier, but it also assisted me with burning videos onto a DVD, transferring multimedia files to an array of devices, converting image formats, and downloading videos from more than 10,000 sites, and recording live computer screens. So you want me to tell you everything? Just install this wonderful software and try its amazing features.